In this video, I'm going to show you a real simple way to make an adult coloring book that you can do with patterns using an app called Repper. I've done a video with Repper before, but in this video, I'm going to show you how to do coloring books really simple with Repper and with Canva. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a coloring book, more specifically an adult coloring book with patterns in it. We're going to use the app called Repper. It's really good at making patterns. I'll show you how to do it. It's super simple. I'm also going to use Canva. I'm going to use Canva to start. I'll show you what kinds of things you'll need with Canva, how I do it anyway, and why I do it. And then we're going to end with Canva because Canva can help you make a PDF. Now, you don't have to use Canva, but I think Canva's a free way to do it. You just need a graphic design app that can actually make a PDF. There's lots of different ways you can do that. But before I get into that, I wanted to show you how popular coloring books are. So you can do coloring books with KDP on Amazon. Here are some of them right here. And you can do coloring books for Etsy, as well as just digital downloads for Etsy. So they're very popular over here. So I would suggest that you go and look at those first, kind of get some ideas what you want to do with it. Do you want a border? What kind of cover you want? Do you want to do digital downloads? How much is it that people pay for these things, and so on. So do some research there. I'm going to show you how to do it. You're going to have to do some research on where to sell it and how much you want to price it and those kinds of things. So let's get into the internet right now. We'll go to Canva first. I'll show you why, and then we're going to go into Repper. So here we are on Canva. The reason why we're here is we want to make a line art, and I'll show you what I did here. So this one is one that I did. All I did was take some different line art and put them here. What we really want is different line weights for Repper so that it can use that to create a pattern. Now, the different line weights are just to make it more interesting. If you have just the same line weights, it's all going to be the same line weight. But if we have different ones like this, then I think it will really help. So let me show you how I did it. I'm going to add a page here, and I'm just going to do elements, and I'm just going to do line art. One word. Boom. And hit will. And then we can just pick any one of these. You can see I picked that one there. This one will do, that one has different line weights. See how it's thick and thin. And then I'm going to scroll down. Let's do some other ones. Now we also want it to be black. That's really key. So come in here, you can see 0000 black. Okay. Let's pick something else. That's kind of cool. That has different line weights. We'll make it bigger. Okay. And let's see. And we want vector one. So if it has color here, if it's just edit, we don't want that. We want something that you can change the color because that means that it's a vector. Let's see. Oh, yeah, this one has a lot of different line weights. I'm going to zoom in like this and we'll put it down here. It doesn't have to make like a pattern or anything. We're just dropping different things in here so that has different line weights. You could also just draw lines. So I'll show you how to do that. We'll go to take this off. We'll do line here, right? And we could make different line weights by just adding different lines here. So I will do this one, and I come in here. Maybe I want this bigger line weight like that. And option shift drag, make a bigger line weight like that, right? And do even bigger, thicker line weight like that. So that's one way you could do it. Let me drop in one more here with the graphics. This guy, well, it's not black, so I'll come in here and turn to black, right? And then maybe one more. Let's do squiggly lines just so we have variety. Squiggly line. Boom. And oh, this is kind of cool, right? Yep, we can color that. Cool. And it's okay if it overlaps. It doesn't matter as long as we have a bunch here. Good. And we have all these right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to export page 2. I'm going to hit that and I'm going to download. And let's just make sure we do page 2 because we already have page 1 like that. And I can make it a PNG. That should be fine. And I'm going to hit done. Download. Okay, so now that it's downloading, let's go into Repr and we can bring this in as an upload and then use this to make our patterns. All right, so here we are on Repr, repr.app. I'm gonna start the app. You're gonna have to sign in with your email and everything. I already signed in, so you can see I can do open an editor, view collection, any of those. I'm gonna close this and you can see it just started. And you can see I've done one here with that that I showed before from Canva. You can see, look at that. This is how it changes. You can see the thick and thin lines, right? Look really good. What I have right now on is metamorphosis. So I'm gonna turn that off for now so you can see that it's just the same pattern. Let's upload and change this. So this one, again, I'm using different, look at that. Just easy to make patterns. Every one of these could be a different page, right? But I'm gonna show you how to change the image. So we're gonna go in here, we're gonna upload, hit upload, and then I'm gonna pick that PNG that we just did. So boom, and there we go. So now we can move that box anywhere around here. You can see it's really neat when we do this one down here with the farm, the thick and thin lines. Isn't that cool? Like that's a coloring page right there, or that, or move it around. Let's do that as the coloring page so you can see how easy it is. So the first thing I would do is find a good spot. I think this is a great spot. And then the next thing I would do is go to tiling and go to this right here, show all patterns. Now it's gonna show you all the different patterns that it can make, and there's a lot, just with that one section that we got. So you can see all of these potentially could be different coloring pages. Just look for the one that you like the best, that you think it would be a great coloring page. And you can size these up and down too, so that even if you see it this big, it can be bigger or smaller, and you see it this small, it could be bigger or smaller, right? So let's do, I think this one's really interesting, this bloom. Yeah, see? Okay, let's say this is the one we wanna do without changing it. Of course, we can change it. But let's go to effects first. Now make sure black and white is turned on. It should be black and white by default, but this will just help it. You can see changing this didn't change the color at all, but we'll turn it on. And we can do higher contrast, but it's already black and white, so it doesn't matter. You just keep it at one. And then the next thing that's really cool is that metamorphosis. So I'm gonna turn that on and you can see that it's changing, which is really cool for coloring books. You can change vertically, or you can change horizontally, going left to right to left, or you don't have to do anything at all. So I like going up and down, but I think it's personal preference. I would do a mix of both, you know, do one page with no metamorphosis, one page with left to right, one page with up and down, and then switch it out again. And then I think the next thing we should do, let's keep that metamorphosis, and let's do export, and we're gonna do custom size. So one of the sizes for the coloring books is 8.5 by 11. So you can see I have it here in inches. And because we're doing it in inches, we're gonna have to do it 300 DPI. And you can have a preview. So this is a preview of what your coloring book would look like. So I think it needs to be bigger. So the way to make it bigger is right here. You can see minus or plus. When I go down, it's really small. When I go up, this is about as big as it can get. So probably somewhere in between. Probably like that, I think is really cool. And now that it's done, I can export it. So I'm just gonna do PNG. You could also do a JPEG. I think they're very similar. So I'm gonna do PNG and we're gonna export this. And I'm just gonna call this pattern one. Now I'm gonna do another one that doesn't have the metamorphosis. So I'm gonna go back to effects, turn off metamorphosis. That's a cool one too, but let's just do a different pattern just for the sake of it. We're gonna do, and I think that would be really fun to do. I'm gonna make it bigger. Yeah, wouldn't that be fun? Okay, so I'm gonna go to effects, not do the metamorphosis, I'm gonna go to export. 8.5 by 11, I think this is good. So I'm gonna say this is pattern two. So export pattern two. And you can see how easy it is. I can make 100 of these really easy. I would suggest do about 50 of these. I think 50 pages is a good size for a coloring book on Amazon or as a digital download. So I did two really easy in less than 2 minutes. So 50 would take you less than an hour, right? And then let's get out of here and let's go back to Canva and I'll show you what to do with these PNGs and how to use it for a coloring book. All right, back on Canva now. We're gonna create a design and I'm gonna just type in coloring book and see if they have it. And they do coloring page, 8.5 by 11, right? Coloring wallpaper, yeah. So we're gonna do this, coloring page. And now you can add, they already have some coloring pages in here, but we're not gonna use those. But you can see these are giving you some good ideas, right? So we could have text in here, not color by number would be kind of fun too, if you wanted to do that. Here's what a coloring book page or a cover could look like, right? So maybe you take this out and put that print we have in the background. That could be really cool. But we're not gonna use any of those right now. I'm gonna go and just drag in the PNGs that we did. So first pattern one, I'll just drag it in here, boom. And I wouldn't do it all the way to the edge, but I would do it, you know, something like that. And then you can center it. The position here is centered, great. You may want a border around there. So I'm gonna do elements and I'm gonna do this guy. And we're just gonna put him right on top. And instead of the color here, we're gonna do no color for the fill. And then we want a border and we want the border weight like that. Good, I think that's great. So if we wanna add more pages, we'll just hit add page and add page. So here you go, I have the pattern one right here and I added pattern two right here. And then I've added a few others that I've done. So you can see I can make multiple pages. Page three, here's another pattern, really simple. Page four, another metamorphosis pattern. Look how cool these are. They're really neat, right? And then I thought, why not put some text with it? So one of the things that you can do to make yours different is to put text with it. So all I did was take some text. This font is called Kare. I believe it is a premium font or a Canva Pro user font, but you don't have to use this font. You can use any of these, you know, that are not, doesn't have the crown. And it just makes it another thing that they can color. So if you wanna put those throughout your coloring book, I think that would be really cool. Another thing you could do is put a shape in here. So all I did was come in here and I searched, so I did black and white line art. And let's see all the graphics. So you can see a bunch of cool things in here. You could also do, this one is a mandala. So I'm gonna do mandala. So you can see a bunch of them. I think this is the one I did, yeah, right here. So if you go magic recommendations, there's a bunch of other ones here that would look really cool. You can put that right in the middle, just as another thing to color. Now we're not just using this by itself, so it makes it so you can use it with the Canva rules. You're not just using it by itself, you're using it with something else. So I think it's great there. Each one could be a different one. You could put this one in a different one or whatever. So just think of that when you're adding things, as well as you can use in Canva frames. So all this is the frame with the letter B. So I'll show you where to do frames. So let's take this out and we'll scroll down here and there's frame. So if you wanna put your pattern in something else, you can. All I did was go down to a letter, right? And have these, I'll show you how to do it. So let's say we want D instead. So we'll put D as big as we want here. And we're just gonna drag in that pattern one again in here and in there. And look at that, there's your D right there. Pretty cool, right? So you could do any one of those. So let's say I have 50 pages now. I only have 8 here, but we're gonna do 50 pages of these with all the different patterns. Do share now, download, and this time we're gonna do PDF print or PDF standard. Either one of these would work as long as it's a PDF. This one's best for printing, so I'm gonna do that. And then I don't need all of these things because we're not gonna actually print it with cutting bleeds and all of that. So, and we can do RGB, but CMYK is best, but it's black and white, so it doesn't really matter. I'll just do CMYK and then we'll hit download. So now, is gonna make a PDF that you can use as a digital download. People will get all the pages at once, or you can upload it to KDP along with your cover. So you can make your cover here too. Let's see, I'm gonna go back home on Canva and type in coloring book cover. And you can see there's a bunch here and you can pick any one of these. I think the one that would match best is kind of like this. It has patterns, but you can look for others if there's other patterns. This is really cool if yours has flowers in it or things like that. Or it doesn't have to be, it could be whatever it is, right? So lots of good ones in here. I'm gonna start with this one and I can customize this template. Boom, you saw some other ones in there. I can resize this, so I can do inches, right? Remember it's 8.5 by 11. Resize, oh, there's already right here. Boom, all right. So I made another one and you can see 8.5 by 11 and you can change this. So you can just say coloring book or pattern coloring book. Right, and make it smaller. Boom, pattern coloring book. Right, and you could put your pattern back here if you want a different pattern or if you want to use this one, it doesn't matter. I think you could also replace your background with the pattern. So if we did the pattern one here, you could put this in the background instead by going to position and layers and now put this in front of it. Boom, right? Pattern coloring book, real simple like that. Make this white since this is black and white. Boom, very simple. Pattern coloring book or whatever you want to call it. There you go, real simple in Canva. Canva has everything and RepGrid does all the patterns for you. So great combo to help you make coloring books and you can scale this. You can keep doing this over and over again. Once you do one with 50, you can go back and make other patterns with other pictures from Canva and so on. So it's really cool. I think it's very scalable. I think it would be fun. So yeah, have fun with this. So there you go. That's how easy it is to make a coloring book. You can do 50 pages. You could do multiple coloring books really quickly with Repr and really nicely with Canva. I think that's a great addition to put those borders and try different shapes with it on top of the patterns, as well as the book cover does really well. So thanks again for watching. If you want to see that first Repr video, if you haven't seen it, kind of going through Repr, I'll put that video right here and you can see all the other things that Repr is good at doing too, not just for coloring books, but for other things like phone cases and pillow cases and pop sockets and the list goes on and on. So as always guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.